If you'd been diagnosed with hepatitis C up until just a few years ago, you'd have faced a long and traumatic period of treatment. Multiple physical side effects, including depression, fatigue, anemia, itchy skin rashes, would combine with increased anxiety, increased irritability, to produce a fairly miserable 6 to 12 months of treatment. To make matters worse, at the end of all that, it may well not have worked. Treatment was only round about 50% successful. In 2011, we got the first of a new batch of drugs called direct-acting antivirals. And these drugs have revolutionized the treatment for hepatitis C. We don't need to use those old toxic treatments anymore. Treatment now lasts between 8 and 12 weeks. It has minimal side effects, and importantly, it works. Treatment's over 90% successful, even in difficult-to-treat groups. So, job done. Almost. Drugs, of course, are only any good if people actually take them. And last year in Scotland, we only managed to treat round about 3% of the estimated 37,000 people living here with the virus. So there's still a lot of untreated hepatitis C about. And untreated hepatitis C can lead to liver cancer, liver cirrhosis, and liver failure. And the costs to the NHS of treating these Hep C-related end-stage liver diseases are estimated to spiral in the coming years. So it's not just a concern for people living with the virus, the burden of Hep C is going to affect us all. My thesis takes this as a starting point and wonders why these rapid advances in treatment haven't resulted in more people being treated. Cost, of course, is a big factor. These drugs don't come cheap. But is there something more to it? Something about the experience, something that the way we understand Hep C as a disease? Has the experience of being hepatitis C positive changed now that it's gone from something which was considered chronic and long-term because of the poor treatment options to something which is very, very treatable and very curable? Or has the understanding of Hep C as a disease remained resolutely stuck in the era of horrific treatment I described at the beginning? What's it like living with Hep C now in the age of the wonder drugs? Is it all hep hooray? Probably not. My early analysis shows that the legacy of these old treatments continues to loom large in the modern experience and understanding of the disease. Thank you. Well.